long enough. I think you know who they are. So for the next 2 hours, you will be underneath the shadow of the porcupine tree.
Washed up on a Norfolk beach. He was a friend that I could not reach. He thought I was cold, but I understand. But for the grace of God goes another. Time ain't just waste away from doing nothing. Time on my turf, to even less.
We'll be right back.
Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank you very much, and good evening. Sorry to keep you waiting. It's been a long time since we were in the States, and I'd like to apologize for that fact and give a special welcome and hello to anybody that may have discovered Porcupine Tree since the last time we were here. And now, is that anyone? Good. We're going to continue with something from the Lightbulb Sun album called She's Moved On.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
the sun is a light bulb. A candle's a treat. The curtains stay closed now on my little retreat. And I'll only take medicine if it's followed by sweets. A sickly pink liquid that puts me to sleep. My head beats a better way. Tomorrow a better day. Watch TV while I'm locked up in bed, and mother makes sure that I'm watered and fed. My best friend from school will come over and stare at me in my bubble. Journey fight. My beats a better way. Tomorrow a better day. When I'm asleep, the smoke fills me. Is making me wish I was back on my feet. Thank you. It's kind of hard to rock out in front of a seated audience. It really is. Okay. Yeah. That wasn't an invitation to stand up. Maybe later. Because we're just about to chill things out a little bit. We'd like to play another track from Lightbulb's Sun album. This is a track that was kind of inspired by something which is not unique to America. But you kind of excel in this particular department. I'm talking about religious cults. You're very good at that here. This is a song that features a sample of a gentleman called Doe, who was the leader of a religious cult called the Heaven's Gate cult, who you may remember from a few years ago, all killed themselves. No, sorry, they didn't kill themselves. They transcended to the next level. This is a track that is titled after the last words on their suicide video, and it's called Last Chance to Evacuate Planet Earth Before It Is Recycled.
Thank you very much.
What the hell did you say?
said you hate me this way. It's just a matter of time. Thank you.
you.
An unplugged set, almost entirely without the aid of any acoustic instruments whatsoever. And this is how we do it. You ready, Richie? Yeah?
You keep me waiting. You keep me alone in a room full of friends. You keep me hating. You keep me listening to the bands. No amount of pointless days could make this go away. You have me on my knees. You have me listless and deranged. You have me in your pocket. You have me distant and estranged. No narcotics in my brain could make this go away. I'm sorry then. I'm sorry that I'm not like you. I'm worried that I don't act the way you want me to. I'm sorry that I'm sorry that I'm not like you. Find me wanting. You find me bloodless but inspired. You find me out. You find me hallucinating fire. No narcotics in my brain can make this go away. I'm sorry that I'm sorry that I'm not like you. I'm worried that I don't act the way you want me to. I'm sorry that I'm sorry that I'm not like you.
Way you
you'd like me to. I don't know how closely you guys follow the news, what's going on in the United Kingdom at the moment, or in fact recently, but we've had a pretty terrible disease sweeping the country, sweeping the nation. You know about that? Yeah, I am of course talking about boy bands and girl bands. It is a fucking disease. And showing no signs of slowing up either. The infection keeps spreading. And I know you have a particular problem with this disease in the United States as well. And in fact, you've sent your disease over to us as well. Thanks. So what we're going to do for you now is a song which is kind of our antidote to the likes of Backstreet Boys, Britney Spears, NSYNC, Christine Aguilera, etc., etc., etc. And the thing about all these musicians, about these artists, is that they purport to perform love songs. And they don't make me feel very romantic somehow. So this is Porcupine Tree's antidote to all of those pointless love songs. Yes, thank you, Colin, for that. And this is called Hate Song.
Yeah. 熱意のユダヤ系の名門で、父は弁護士。はじめ法律を学んだが、映画に情熱を覚え、パリのシネマテイクに通い、トリフォーやゴダールらと知り合い、短編映画を撮ったりした。64年、世界の動乱のフィルムを3年がかりで編集したドキュメンタリー、革命の川を完成して注目される。80年、アメリカのペントハウスと提携したプリギュラーはセンセーショナルな内容で、世界各国で大きな話題を呼んだ。
We'll be right back. very much. Good night.
Okay. We're going to play... No, I'm sorry, we don't do requests, okay? What we are going to do for you is a track from Stupid Dream album now. This is about the saddest song in the whole Porcupine Tree catalogue, which is Saying Something. Okay? But for me, the saddest things, saddest songs, were also always the most beautiful and the most uplifting. Maybe that's just me. This is called Stop Swimming.
And I know that
that the lived can be painfully slow. So I think I'll leave by the willow. Oh, oh. Hear softly.
Thank you very much, and good night. Thank you. Okay, you can stay standing for this one, actually, if you like. This is a bit bouncy. This is called Voyage 34.
This remarkable, sometimes incoherent transcript illustrates a phantasmagoria of fear, terror, grief, exultation, and finally breakdown. Its highlights have been compressed on this recording to make their own disquieting points. Participants have eaten sugar cubes saturated with LSD. We hear Brian and his fellow travelers observing their gradual transformation. Thank you. things by chewing on some plastic flash bulbs. Changing. He orders all of his friends into another room, closes the door. He sits alone on the wooden floor, visible only by the dim light shining from the bathroom. He talks to himself. Snap his fingers and terminate the trip, which continues. We'll be right back. ended 12 hours after it so innocently had begun. He was shattered by it.
This young man never had a bummer in some 33 LSD trips. Every one of them was a delight. Everything under control. He needed only to snap his fingers, and down he came any time. But on voyage 34, he finally met himself coming down an up staircase, and the encounter was crushing.
Thanks for listening. We'll see you next time. to destroy. Give me radioactive toy. Run through graveyards on a dusty winter's day. Spit the dirt out and try to say, give me the freedom to destroy.